So, for number 63, this one in particular has a lot more dynamic and stylistic things marked in that we can do as a way to really exaggerate those so that the judge knows that they were intentional. As one of my former professors used to always say, you know you did a decrescendo, and I know you did a decrescendo, but no one in the audience does. So the thing is you want to make it very, very apparent. Also, this is one of those issues that happens a lot when we're practicing etudes for solos or also contest etudes, which is that opening dynamic of piano. Now, when you play in middle school, you ultimately see piano and you think as soft as you can possibly play. But remember that there's another dynamic below that, which is pianissimo. And technically there's another triple piano, and then there's quadruple piano, and then there's niente. So there's four levels below that. So the thing is that whenever you see piano marked when you're playing by yourself, you want to adjust that accordingly. So start more mezzo piano. But this is an opportunity on this one for the first four measures to go from piano to double forte, which we want to think of as a full, as loud as you can play with a good sound, you know. So you're going to start soft, build all the way up to that fortissimo, then immediately start again. On the third line, we have pianissimo to start that line, followed by mezzo forte. Now remember, mezzo forte isn't super loud, but compared to pianissimo, which is probably our baseline for the softest we would be comfortable playing, then jumping up to a mezzo forte, that's going from piano, that's from pianissimo to piano to mezzo piano to forte. So that's jumping up four levels. So you want to make sure that that's a big transition, for instance. So you want to make sure that it's a very significant change when you do that. Now, at the same time, when you build at the end of the third line and you have that same kind of pattern when you go up to forte again, now this time I like to have a little crescendo that builds into the fourth line, so that we make it that much more dramatic when we come all the way down to piano in the next measure and then immediately back up again. So this one, the most important thing is to focus on your dynamic contrast and also paying attention to the articulation. There's a lot written in on this one where we have a combination of legato, accented legato, and staccato. So really make sure that all of those sounds are specifically different. Also, one of my big things, as all of my students know, in the first measure of the last line, watch out for recurring accidentals, which means that B at the end of the measure is a B natural. So I would definitely mark that as well as the B flat in the following measure to make sure you don't get that confused. All right, good luck. Happy practicing.